main theme echoes and celebrating anniversaries, of which we now have the Max Reger anniversary that we can experience here with the Lundén organ, the largest historical organ in late Romantic style in Gothenburg. And we, 2 hours ago, we heard the 15 inventions by Johann Sebastian Bach with the third part composed by Reger in his arrangement. And tomorrow at 1 o'clock we will hear here in the Vasa Church chamber music, a clarinet sonata and a cello sonata with excellent musicians and Bengt Forsberg at the piano. And tomorrow afternoon in the concert hall, Isabel de Meurs is also going to play one of the major Reger works. But as the main celebration of Reger's organ music, it's been wonderful to see here and sense how our participants have enjoyed working with one of the absolutely leading experts on Max Reger's music here in the mornings in the workshop. And we are going to have our friend and faculty member since long in the Göteborg International Organ Academy, now the festival, performing for us. Professor of organ in Stuttgart and with us now tonight, please help me welcome Lutke Lohmann.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this concert, which will be hard stuff both for me and for you. I am going to play three of the most important organ pieces by Max Reger, and let me just give you a few explanations, particularly on the piece in the middle of the program, the F-sharp minor variations, because that is a piece which is very difficult to understand. The first piece I'm going to play is the Chorale Fantasia, Hallelujah, Gott zu loben. This is a piece which marks the end of a development. Reger, when he was a student, had a serious physical and mental breakdown, so his parents took him back home. He was by that time in his early 20s, and during the following years, he composed 7 Chorale Fantasias. Almost all of them, maybe with the first exception, Ein Festeburg, deal with the topic of pain, suffering, and then also salvation, which can be seen as being something like a psychological treatment which he gave to himself in order to overcome these serious problems he had before. And Hallelujah, Gott zu loben, which is the last in this cycle, is actually the final solution, so everything seems to be okay. The text is very friendly, is very jubilant, and the piece has a long fugue, which is always a good sign, a sign that order has been restored after so much suffering. So this piece resembles partly a little bit more a Baroque chorale partita, because the verses follow each other without any major interludes. The F-sharp minor variations, Reger wrote them at a point in his career where he was already very well received by the public, also by music critics. It is a kind of mysterious piece because it does not follow the usual recipes of variation writing. The first thing to know is that there is a lengthy introduction, and sometimes it is not so easy to understand immediately when the real subject comes. But I can tell you it's about 5 minutes. 5 minutes into the piece, you will hear, after a lot of chaos, both in pianissimo and in fortissimo, you will hear something which sounds like a melody with accompaniment, and that is the subject. Now, the variations are not just going on the subject, but they also take some material from the introduction, some smaller motifs on which some variations are based. In some variations, Reger also uses such small motifs together with material from the subject proper. Reger never liked to talk a lot about his own pieces, but in that case he said, well, this piece was born out of a great melancholic mood. I think he explains it in German, große Wehmut, which is even more than melancholy. And you can hear that all over the piece. And he particularly refers to a certain measure in the subject, and maybe you will keep that little motif. It's only a motif of three notes by the end of the day. Ta-da-ta-ta-dum. So this ta-ta-dum is a motif which plays a major role, also in its inversion, ta-da-tum. That already appears quite often in the introduction. So very often he works only with this little motif. And then I have to say also that the variations are done in several groups, and it is always so that during a group, which consists usually of three or four variations, he initiates something like a destructive process. So the parameters of the subject are destroyed more and more, and after that, he comes back to the original atmosphere of the theme. By the end of the day, we have a lovely, playful fugue, which seems to solve all the problems we had before. Finally, the last big organ piece he wrote and published 4 weeks before he died, the Fantasia in D minor, a piece which is also based basically on a very short motif of four notes, da da ti dum, and that motif appears in all kinds of combinations, also sometimes switching positions of notes, so sometimes you don't even feel it's the motif which is present, but you can trust me, it goes throughout the whole piece. The fugue is a double fugue, which first has a very somber subject, again constructed only out of those four notes, and then follows a playful dance like jig, also constructed the initial motif of this fugue is also taken from those four notes. And then, of course, at the end, those two subjects are combined. In this piece, I see Reger's reaction to not only his own personal problems, also health problems, but also to the situation at the beginning of the First World War. All this suffering and this reflection on the pain that other people have to endure during those years is expressed in his last big organ piece. So I hope you will in some way enjoy this concert.
Also warmly welcome to you who follow through the live stream this concert. And right at the time when these works were built, Eski Lundén built the organ here, 1909, in the Vasa Church. So it's really an instrument with the sounds inspired from his visit in Berlin with Sauer, the sounds from this time and this cultural context. So we look forward very much to listening to these three major works tonight in the concert with Ludger Lohmann.